journalists and people like myself, we are not welcome in Pakistan. In Pakistan, ISI runs its own government. It's a state within a state. The people living in Pashtun areas, in the farther region of Pakistan, have suffered tremendously. And I think it was about time Pashtuns stood up for their rights. And I wish them all the best. And we offer this uprising our full support. And I think once we are all united on one platform, I'm sure we will see a Pakistan which is controlled by Pakistanis, not by just Punjabis. International community could tie their grant and support for Pakistan with Pakistan's actual human rights record. If Pakistan improves it, the money could go towards Pakistan. If it fails, the money could be stopped. Luckily, we are witnessing all the right signs, and it looks pretty obvious that our efforts are yielding results here. A few things already have come in the media, and we are expecting a few more important developments in near future, which eventually give a lot of leverage to Muhajirs as well as other oppressed ethnic and religious groups in Pakistan. Pashtuns who live abroad, they should and they could play an important role. I think Pashtun diaspora living overseas should be more active in contacting with international media. Pakistan's military establishment created an environment where Pashtun and Muhajirs didn't get along, and in fact there were some bitter incidents between them. Good thing is now both have learned lessons. They both now have realized who is oppressing them. We have very strong relationship with our Pashtun brothers, and I am expecting some really positive changes. We don't care about the consequences. We don't think about the end result. We are dealing with what is, you know, just the objective right before our eyes, and we are focused on that. The world is a global village now. There is no room for extremism anymore. We all need inclusiveness, especially in societies like Pakistan.